procedure. Yeah, this is the procedure. So normally, the procedure starts with, identifying the goals. You have to go back and talk to your management. What is your goal? And identify priority. So you have to identify what you want to measure, what are the resources available, and then how much facility you want to evaluate. And then come up with a plan, identify required data and develop data collection plan. When you want to do collect data, normally use a standard template. So that template I will show you. We try to upload this template or share with you. If you are interested, we share with you. Today I am not giving, but once I take the question, so those who are expressed to participate in this study, I will share the template with you. And then collect the data. Normally the collection of data, takes some time, depending on whether you have instruments or not. So some of you may have equipment to monitor, so you can collect the data easily. If you don't have, then install a monitoring equipment, maybe to help of us collect the data. Then you pass the information to us to, analyze and prepare the benchmarking report. So this is the standard procedure for collecting the benchmarking study. And then there will be template, I will show you later. But once you have a template, you can see you have certain indicators like A1. So here you will try to measure these parameters. Several parameters, and similarly, because when you are measuring energy efficiency indicator, you may want to measure for cooling, or you may want to. Once you have done the study, you know what is your data center PUE. You also know what is the average PUE of the whole set, and you also know what is the PUE of the somebody else. So if somebody has a PUE very low, that means you are behind. Right. That's why I showed 4 benchmarking study reports. US, Europe, Singapore. All are in same. When Singapore did this study, their results are comparable with EU and US. Fine. That means they said, okay, we are as good as US and we are as good as Europe. But if you look at Japan, when they did the benchmarking study, Japan did benchmarking study is 1.8 average PUE. So that means they are ahead. That means all the people have implemented or actually operating their data center efficiently. So if that is a benchmark for rest, everybody who is above 2.2 can improve. Even the Japan is trying to improve to better. Actually, the main idea of doing the study is to get what is the average value. Anybody is behind the average value need to do some initiative. Okay. Those who are ahead of the average value don't need to worry, but they can take a leap. Maybe they can go and talk to other people how to. They can be sharing their experience with symposium. They can attend a cloud expo. Okay, so there is a data collection on the temperature side. So again, coming to the temperature side, so this is a standard you are operating temperature less than 60 degrees Fahrenheit in your data center, that is very standard, you know, it's good. But if you can operate your data center above 74 degrees, it's better. Okay, so these are the, as per the guidelines of the ASHRAE. So this is the ASHRAE guideline. ASHRAE guideline actually shows, you can see what is the supply air temperature range, the lower setting and higher setting. Look at this data. This data, this is standard. This temperature index is coming from ASHRAE, you know. And each data center is coming at different strong. You can identify where your data center is. It here or here, here. If you are somewhere down below here, that means you are operating your data center very cool. You can actually go up, because this is the recommended margin for reducing energy consumption in the cooling system. I give you an example. In my previous university, you know, coming to the humidity, humidity also is very important. So the humidity, standard humidity operated is between 40% to 55%. If you can operate slightly longer range, it's better, good. If you have no control, then it's even better. But it depends on your data center business. So this is a guideline for humidity. So this is the recommended upper limit. So ASHRAE recommended lower limit is 42 minimum dew point. So you can see here many data center are here and here. Actually these are all the different data center ID. So you can see most of them are between this range and only very few are global. Similarly, you have a air inlet temperature. So air inlet temperature, you can see the range. Okay. So you can calculate the return temperature index RTI based on the formula shown here, and then these are the parameters to monitor. What is the supply air temperature, return air temperature, rack inlet mean temperature, rack outlet, and then so these are the range of operation. So based on your data, there is always what to be done, actions required and special considerations. Okay, so this is about you know, some procedure, and I show you. You normally collect. So you can type the project name or company name. Then yeah, I think this one. Okay, so here you can see example. So this is a template. Normally you can just use this template. We can share this template with you, or we also try to upload this template on the website. So you can see the different indices I just now mentioned. So you try to collect the data, and then here there is an indicator. Okay, color code also shown. So the green one shows that it's important. Then the next important is shown with the lighter green or 2. Then the least one is shown with the 3. Actually, you can also collect this information, okay, but the importance level is less compared to the other. So these are all the various data you can collect from your data center to evaluate different metrics, you know, related to power, related to cooling, and related to air management, okay, and related to data center energy data or general data center data. Remember one thing here, this is general data collection, you know, for DC. Whichever data you can measure, then you can control that. If you can measure, you can control. If you are not measuring, you are not controlling. Very simple. If you want to improve energy efficiency in any section, then you have to start getting the data in that segment. Okay. Once you can collect the data for all the sections, then you are actually able to see full picture of your data center. And okay, once you collect this data on the shown on this page 1, then the metrics will be coming here. So you can compute the metrics using this parameter here. And there is one more. Actually, the previous one is for those who are energy manager or operator, because they are familiar with how to collect the data or they know how to measure the data. Okay, but some of you may not be having any idea, you know. So this kind of a template will be very useful. So you can see here, okay, this template is developed by, again, the Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory in collaboration with, you know, Energy Research Institute or EPRI. Utility input voltage, what is your UPS input voltage, UPS output voltage, what is the N size of your UPS module in kilowatt, you know, what is the UPS design topology. So UPS design topology, you can see here, many, double conversion, delta conversion, rotary, flywheel. So for every question, you have choice whether your data center have N or N plus 1 or 2N. So this questionnaire actually helps all the data center to, you know. Similarly, coming back here, what is the lighting density of in raised floor area? You don't know, you actually have, you know, more than 1.5 watt per square feet or less than 1.5 watt per square feet. So that means there is a standard there. So if you are in more than 1.5 or less than 1.5, you know what to do. Similarly, coming down here, okay, here, what is the load factor per active UPS module? You can click here and see what are the options. Less than 25%, between 25-50 or more than 50. So based on this selection, right now it is in 25-50. I change here, or I change here. You see, if it is more than 50%, you don't need to do anything there. potential action. So it tells based on where you are. If you select here, it's more than 50%, you don't need to do anything. But if you say you are here, then it will tell, okay, do this, step by step. So this is a very detailed one. It takes time to go through. Similarly here, okay, if it is less than 96%, you retrofit UPS. But if it is more than 96%, no need to do anything. Okay, if you say, oh, I don't know. Right now you may want to say, you don't know. Then, evaluate UPS efficiency at 50% load factor. So this survey, this template is for you to help yourself. But when you do yourself, some things are gray. Then you have to call, you know, how to key in, or how to measure, or what to do. So there we try to help. Or, not me, I'm not an expert in all area, but I'm head of this project or doing this project. What we are trying to do is, I jump to the next session, we are trying to create a platform, community platform, where all of us will be there, can share information, you know, collaborate, and do what is necessary to improve the energy efficiency. Okay, so that is template. Actually, take an example. If it is less than 0.9, you know, improve power factor at the main feeder, you know, to be more than 0.9. Why? Because if you are less than 0.9, you may be paying the penalty for TNP as stipulated in the tariff. Normally, the penalty for power factor is only for commercial and industry, not for residential. So if it is more than 0.9, no need to do anything. If you say I don't know, investigate building power factor. So this is about the template. So then after you complete the template with all the details, the results will be displayed here. UPS load factor, then ID power density. Okay. Then you can also get the UPS efficiency here. Goals. Okay, at the end of the day, all this information has to be analyzed and you know, then only identify what are the possible measures to improve the efficiency. So what we are trying to do is, we are trying to, and then remember, this is not a very simple task, because each data center assessment will take at least 6 weeks actually, you know, if you want to do completely. And then again, it varies from small data center to big data center.